Next on Thames, another chance to see Monday's Wish You Were Here programme, which features Britain, the Italian Riviera, and the Seychelles.
Ready, ready, brush like sponge, smooth plain chocolate, and a smashing double mint.
Munchkins, they know only McVitie's baked the terrific taste of the original Jaffa Cakes. So they're over the moon about them. Only McVitie's baked the original Jaffa Cakes.
The oldest sale is open New Year's Day. Whatever you're looking for, you're going to find a real bargain. From beds, to furniture, to electrical goods, and fashion. The oldest sale. If you're looking for a bargain, we're going to give you a wonderful surprise.
You're buying the leading powder. Will you swap for Daz?
No, because I'm not happy with what I've got.
So, Linda, we persuaded you to try Daz in the hot whites wash.
Yes, I'm very pleased with it. This is my son's school T-shirt, and that comes home every 6 weeks from school, and it's really grubby, and it came up nice and white. These are muslin nappies that I use for mopping up on the baby, and they came up really white. I get through quite a lot of powder. Daz is cheaper, so therefore it saves me money on my housekeeping.
So would you swap for two packets of your old powder?
No, I'm sticking to Daz. I wouldn't change back now.
Try Biological Daz yourself in the hot whites wash. Most women agree Daz gives unbeatable white at a price that's right.
He's coming round. He's coming round. Give him air.
Give him air.
Mr. Smith.
Where am I?
You're in Lun Polly, the holiday shop.
Lun Polly?
You fainted.
Must be the heat.
It's our discounts. Up to £25 off Thompson, Intersand, Wings, Cosmos, Sovereign.
Up to £25 off?
That's per person.
Per person.
Other agents don't. Lun Polly does.
Morning.
The chef in charge of Findus Crispy Pancakes takes his job very seriously. Whether he's inspecting ingredients or studying serving suggestions, he never stops. He's even been known to take his work home with him. Findus Crispy Pancakes. The finest food, frozen.
You'd never soak your face in dirty dishwater, nor rub in household cleaner, or even dab on scourer. Yet you do it to your hands every day. But rub in a Trixo, and your hands will be protected, even in water, and still be soft when the work's done. So care for your hands as much as your face with a Trixo. Keep it on hand all through the day.
Look at a new gas fire now, and you'll see how they've changed. A new gas fire, welcoming controllable heat at the heart of your home. Isn't it time you came home to the comfort of a new gas fire? Gas. No wonder people prefer it.
Now then, film fans, if you're still recovering from Oklahoma and you stay with us here on Thames and the Surrey of the Fringe on top, we've got in-flight film entertainment all the way. At 1:30 this afternoon, there's Disney's The Island at the Top of the World. At 9 o'clock tonight, Christopher Reeve stars in Monsignor. And at 12:30, just to keep you bopping into the new year, the late-night movie is Breakdance. Plenty of movie entertainment. We hope that you'll be there throughout. And now we move on to Wish You Were Here.
Thank you.
week, dream holidays in the Seychelles. Village pubs that offer bed and breakfast, as well as bangers and beer. Packages by the Italian seaside, and a short break by coach to the West Country. Hello, and the very warmest of welcomes to the new series of Wish You Were Here. We're down in Devon to celebrate our return and the festive season in true party spirit. Now that Christmas and New Year are fast becoming one long holiday, many more hotels around the country, like this one in Babbicombe, are organising special short seasonal holidays, quite apart from the enormous variety of short breaks they run throughout the winter. There are so many holidays now, it really is quite baffling, but that's where we come in to help you find the right holiday for you. In the next few weeks on Wish You Were Here, we'll be reporting on old favourites such as Blackpool, Benidorm and Cornwall. We'll be investigating new holiday areas like Turkey and Malaysia, and we'll be seeking out those unsung British bargains in farms and guest houses. Occasionally there'll be a touch of luxury, but overall there'll be a lot of reasonably priced and practical family ideas. We begin with a typical Mediterranean packaged holiday on Italy's Ligurian Riviera. Chris Kelly made the 1.5 hour flight from London to Genoa and then had a further 90 minutes drive to Diano Marina, sandwiched between Alassio and San Remo. He found, though, that generations of holidaymakers had beaten him to it.
For 100 years and more, the British have been holidaying on this stretch of the Italian Riviera. Diano Marina is a busy little town. It's not for ravers, despite its dozen discos. Families like it because the beaches are safe. They're either sand or sand and pebble and shelve gently into the sea. The Italians don't take kindly to being organised, especially by their government, but their beaches are the most organised in Europe. Just under half this beach area is public and free. The rest is split among concessionaires, so you have to pay for changing rooms, deck chairs and umbrellas. Now then, do you want to sunbathe first, second or third class? It's a bit like the theatre. From the third row back, it costs slightly over £3 a day. That's in the gods. Second row from the front is the dress circle, and for about £1 extra, you get the front stalls, right next to the sea. These prices are cheaper outside the July-August high season. One advantage of this rather regimented system is that you do get a clean beach. They practically hoover the sand every evening, including the public beaches. Every section has its lifeguard. Liguria is the Italian name for the region. The Queen Mother holidayed on this coast as a child, and Charles Dickens called it the most beautiful part of Italy. Genoa is the gateway. The city has built a stylish new airport. British Caledonian flies here from London Gatwick 6 days a week, year round. Until the end of June, the cheapest Apex return fare is £201. It has to be booked at least 2 weeks ahead, and you have to stay in Italy for a Saturday night. When you come off the plane, you have an hour and a half journey to Diano and its twin resort, San Bartolomeo. But what a journey! 100 miles of road between Genoa and the French frontier is one of the most exciting motorways in Europe. The Italians call it the Autostrada of the Flowers. Even in winter, the temperature rarely drops below 50 degrees, and flower growing is the biggest industry after tourism. And after the sunny climate, what do British visitors like most about this holiday? Answer, Italian food. In Diano Marina, there's a cafe or restaurant every few yards. Most British visitors are in half-board hotels and go for a light lunch of pizza or pasta. One of Italy's best-known spaghetti factories is just down the road. Dinner is a different story. Don't aim to lose weight on this holiday. The fish comes fresh from the sea, the vegetables fresh from the market gardens, and the locally pressed olive oil on your salad is claimed to be the finest in Italy. I've just had a lovely three-course lunch here at the seaside, and the damage, including wine, only came to £10. But that's 20,000 lira. Paying bills here involves an awful lot of noughts and an awful lot of notes. It's like wheelbarrow money. You need one to cart the stuff around in. Era delizioso. 20 milliliters, see?
See?
This could change towards the end of this year if the government goes ahead and introduces what they're calling the heavy lira. Then, instead of about 2,000 lira for your pound, you'll get just two.
Va bene. Grazie.
I spent more than a note or two in the market. Tuesday is market day. The Corso Roma is closed to traffic, and there's half a mile of shopping on both sides of this main street. Popular buys are leather goods, tablecloths, and silk scarves. And all this under the orange trees for which Diana Marina is famous. Incidentally, don't bother to haul duty-free bottles to Italy. Popular brands of whiskey and other spirits sell here for much the same price you pay in duty-free shops at British airports. Accommodation ranges from pensions to four-star hotels, some with swimming pools. You usually have to cross the road to reach the beach. Most hotels are three-star, which puts Diana Marina in the middling price range for an Italian holiday. Many British visitors stay at this three-star hotel in the centre of town. Its bedrooms are more spacious than some others we saw. The supplement for a sea view and balcony is about a pound a night, and worth it, since the hotel is only yards from the sea. The day starts with a buffet breakfast. Then, if you don't feel up to learning dinghy sailing or windsurfing at the nearby sailing club, there's always the hotel's Keep Fit room. An excursion boat runs half-day trips for £6 or £7 to see the famous Riviera resorts Alassio and San Remo from the sea. But most people do their own thing for excursions. They just buy a ticket at the railway station. It's a spectacular line hugging the rocky coast. Mile for mile, Italian railways are about the cheapest in Western Europe. Treat yourself to a first-class ticket to Alassio, and you'll pay a fraction of what this 20-minute journey would cost at home. At Alassio, and everywhere else along the Riviera, the train sets you down right in the middle of town. It's a 2-minute walk to the elegant Café Roma for a cappuccino or an espresso coffee. And across the street, you can do some celebrity spotting on the Muretto, a low wall where plaques record the names of famous people who stayed here. Ernest Hemingway's parrot has long survived the American writer himself and still lives in the Café Roma. While in the nearby gardens, children play under the statue of a familiar figure in baggy trousers. A step away from the bustle of the Riviera coast is Old Liguria. Vast churches, steep, shadowed alleyways, ancient buildings, all cling to the rocky slopes. Cervo, built centuries ago at a safe height and distance from Saracen raiders and other seaborne enemies, is easily reached from anywhere on Diana Marina Bay. 5 minutes' walk from the main road is this peaceful little spot, Our Lady of the Oak Tree, with its pilgrim's church. A slow, twisty road winds along this coast, and surprisingly, it's Italy's national highway number one. That's because it's so historic. The Roman Emperor Marcus Aurelius built it. It began in Rome and ended, just imagine, around 2,000 miles away in Gibraltar, some road. And don't be tempted to rush it, otherwise you'll miss great views like this one.
Chris Kelly on the Italian Riviera. Now, the price of that package deal to the Palace Hotel in Diano Marina ranges from £432 for 2 weeks half board in May, rising to £546 in August. That includes return flights from Gatwick, although the same holiday is also available by rail. Here in Babbacombe, this seaside hotel not only celebrates Christmas and the New Year, but also takes short break coach tours from February to the end of April. Set in a quiet side road, the adjoining Tracarn and Oswald's have been knocked into one typically British resort hotel. Meals are taken at set times, with dinner starting promptly at 6:30. The three-course menu offers a reasonable choice of dishes. There's some form of live entertainment on all short breaks, and nightly dancing has a deft touch of class about it. Most bedrooms are a moderate size and simply furnished, although all have tea-making facilities and television, and a private bath or shower with loo. This winter's short breaks restart in February when they cost £69, rising to £86 at the end of April. For that, you get two lunches, two sightseeing excursions, and insurance. Over Christmas and the New Year, the cost increases by up to £100 or so. And by the way, there are dozens of departure points, mainly from the northeast, Yorkshire and southern England. This is Babbacombe Seafront, a local beauty spot and less than 5 minutes' walk from the hotel. Down the coast, about 2 miles away, is the centre of Torquay. It's just about the nearest we get to a Mediterranean Riviera, even down to its own brand of spiky palms. With a normally mild climate, it's a popular choice for off-season coach breaks. Much closer to the hotel, though, is this attractive pedestrian shopping street. And now for our second holiday report. During the series, we shall be looking at new trends in British holidays. And we start right here with the village pub. You may not believe it, but many of Britain's 70,000 pubs are said to be going into decline. And that's simply because people aren't going out as much for a drink. So pubs are having to sell themselves. And many of them are now offering bed and breakfast. The revival is being masterminded by the Brewer Society, who ran a pilot scheme in Cheshire last year, including several hundred pubs. And publication of this special guide was part of it. Cheshire was picked for the first guide because it's typical of the national situation. While Chester, the main town, invariably overflows with visitors, the surrounding countryside and its pubs remain comparatively neglected. So, it's little places like Malpas, 15 miles outside Chester, and they say the third smallest town in Britain, that the guide hopes to put on the tourist map. In the 1800s, when Malpas lay on the main coaching route to London, 100 visitors a day would stop here as the coaches changed horses. The coming of the railways killed that trade, however, and left Malpas the quiet backwater you see today. But it's a good base for sightseeing in Cheshire and neighbouring North Wales. And as the guide will tell you, there are two pubs here with rooms to let, the Old Vaults and the Red Lion. It doesn't look it from the outside, but the Red Lion goes back to the 13th century. King James I ate here one night and supposedly sat on this chair. Happily, the owners haven't felt moved to rip out all this and replace it with plastic. It helps that they're a free house and can therefore sell a range of beers that real ale enthusiasts approve of. Since taking the pub over 10 years ago, Bill and Sheila Lever have made a number of improvements. In the days when it was Malpas's chief coaching inn, this would have been full of horses. They've converted one stable to bring in extra trade. But upstairs, it's the new bedrooms that they're pinning their hopes on. They've converted 5 rooms for visitors, about the average we found among bed and breakfast pubs. Although they're fairly small, they don't go short on modern touches. Each one has its own shower, wash basin and loo. And this room interlinks with an adjoining one, useful for a family. Bed and breakfast charges at pubs go from £8 or £9 a night in some parts of the country, right up to £20. The Levers are charging £13.95 a head, and that includes a proper cooked breakfast. You can also have dinner here for about £4.95 a head. 4,000 pubs now do B&B. Country pubs like the Red Lion certainly make good bases for touring. And being less formal and cheaper than hotels, and livelier than many guest houses, they offer a particularly good way of getting to know local people and of picking up tips on the things worth doing and seeing in the area. According to Bill, people ask him if Malpas knows there have been 2 world wars, it's so quiet. But both he and Sheila think visitors appreciate the chance to get away from noise and bustle. They certainly hope so, because without new trade, country pubs like this, centuries ago the only place visitors could stay at, might soon cease to exist. Well, you'll find the Red Lion, along with 700 other pubs, in this booklet, which costs £1.95, and you can buy it from Cheshire's tourist information centres and leading news agents. But back now to our short break in Devon. We're off on one of the 2 excursions that are included in the price of this coach tour to Babbacombe. One reassuring feature of holidays like these is that you're looked after all the time. The charm of Devon is its gentle countryside, even in winter. If it's Wednesday, it must be Newton Abbot. The weekly market is included in a half-day tour. Our final holiday report comes from one of the world's most romantic spots, the Seychelles. Annika Rice took the 11.5-hour flight via Bahrain to the main island of Mahé before flying on to Pralin for the second part of a two-centre holiday. She also hopped across to Bird Island on an unusual side trip.
Nobody really knows how many islands make up the Seychelles. 100 at the last count. Some are so small they come and go with the tide. For once, the picture postcards barely do justice to the place, and the atmosphere is so relaxed, even the palm trees are laid back. The Seychelles were first discovered in 1502, and then promptly forgotten again. They continue to snooze away happily, far from the main sea routes, until 15 years ago. Then they built Seychelles International Airport on the main island of Mahé, and the tourists began to arrive. Not that tourism has exactly galvanised Victoria, the capital and the only town in the Seychelles. Languid is too urgent a word to describe the pace. Even a souvenir-sized version of Big Ben can't summon up the energy to chime, and life goes on around it in slow motion. The nearest thing to bustle in Victoria is the market. The stalls are heaped with pineapples, mangoes and coconuts and fish. Red snapper is one of 900 varieties of fish which swim around the islands, and the best way to see them without getting your feet wet is on a half-day trip by glass-bottom boat into the Marine National Park. It costs £9. It's like watching a floating television set. Beneath the glass, shoals of technicolour fish flit among the coral. Dangle a chunk of bread in the water and it's reduced to crumbs in minutes. Seychelles Airport also has its toes in the water. The British Airways flights leave London every Tuesday, arriving at Mahé around 11 the following morning. Since my visit, though, they've introduced 747s on the route. For independent travellers, the lowest apex fare is £648 return. You have to pay 30 days in advance, your minimum stay is 14 days, and you can't alter your flight without paying a supplement. Most of the big hotels are scattered around Victoria, in the north of Mahé. There are no concrete skylines. By law, no hotel must be taller than the surrounding palm trees. But you don't have to stay in a hotel. The Seychelles Tourist Board published this list, available in Britain, of traditional guest houses, and they're often cheaper and much more atmospheric. The Lazare Pico guest house straggles down a hillside in the south of Mahé, almost part of the scenery. The steeply terraced chalets have coconuts around the door instead of roses. A half-board deal here makes sense. A double room ranges from around £43 to £51 a day, depending on the time of year, and it includes breakfast and dinner for two. Furnishings are simple, but they all have their own showers and ceiling fans. All the chalets overlook the sweep of Lazare Bay and its perfect white sand beach. There are 68 beaches on Mahé, and the main ones are linked by a cheap and efficient bus service. Beau Vallon Bay is the most famous, a swathe of dazzling chalky sand buttressed by modern hotels, and the springboard for just about every water sport in the book. But to reach the really secluded beaches, you'll need one of these. They cost around £25 a day. That includes insurance and unlimited mileage, you'll be glad to hear, but not petrol. Mahé rises to 3,000 feet at Mont Seychellois, the highest peak in the Indian Ocean. Drive south and the roads unravel like a skein of wool. Leggy forests of coconut palms parade by the roadside. Village houses peep through the camouflage of banana plantations. Jungly tracks lead down to beaches where you're almost sure to be completely on your own. a sense, Mahé is only the bus stop for the other islands. Each one has its own individual character, and there are plenty of island-hopping excursions by plane or ferry. This, to my mind, is where the escapism really begins. The trip to Tiny Bird Island takes 30 minutes, but what a contrast. This is what I've been waiting for. On landing, you're welcomed by the island's owner, and from then on, you're part of the family. The hotel, well, there's nothing else, consists of palm-thatched huts, equipped with all mod cons, but somehow still straight out of Robinson Crusoe. The cost of the flights and an overnight stay with all meals, which were excellent, is about £148. The island has a wraparound beach. They say you can walk around it in an hour, but nobody ever does. Who could resist the temptation to just sit and look? And of course, there are the birds, nearly 3 million of them at some times of the year, a birdwatcher's dream. The oldest inhabitant is Esmeralda, the transvestite tortoise. She's 200 years old. She is actually a he, but the name stuck. Some holiday operators wrap up more than one island in a single package. Well, back on Mahé, we looked at a deal which gives you two islands for the price of one. The North Home Hotel, overlooking Beauvallon Bay, is one half of a two-centre holiday. You spend a week here, followed by a week on Pralin. The air-conditioned rooms face the bay, and you get your own bathroom. The package is either bed and breakfast or half board. Otherwise, dinner is £13 a head. And if you fancy a bottle of wine, be prepared for an instant hangover. In common with most hotels, the cheapest bottle is £10, and a bottle of local beer costs £1. The beach below the hotel is popular with snorkelers. Many hotels provide snorkeling equipment, and the waters teem with fish, but leave your spear gun behind. They're forbidden by law. Now for the bird's eye view. The transfer from Mahé to Pralin takes 15 minutes by twin otter or trilander. On Pralin, you stay at the Flying Dutchman Hotel. Accommodation is in rondavels or with their own showers. The beach is only yards from the hotel restaurant. Here you can take a step back into prehistory. The Vallée de Mai is a humid and ghostly palm forest where the house plants are bigger than most people's houses. It looks like the world on the day of creation, and the resemblance doesn't end there. In 1831, General Gordon of Khartoum stood here and he claimed he discovered the original Garden of Eden. And this is the reason why. The huge Coco de Mer nut, which grows nowhere else in the world. Gordon took one look at it and declared it was the biblical forbidden fruit, no less. Peeled and polished, the government-protected nuts are sold as souvenirs for as much as £70.
I think I could see what Gordon was getting at.
At least one man thought the Seychelles paradise, and it's a word much bandied about in the brochures. But does the reality live up to the fantasy?
A word of warning, the Seychelles are expensive, so if you're only on bed and breakfast, you'll really find the extras beginning to pile up. Another thing, it is very laid back here. So if you're the type of person that likes everything done just like that, well, it's never going to happen.
But for many people, the slowness is part of the charm. Winding down is what tropical holidays are all about. Anyway, it's a small price to pay for all this.
Well, that two-island package starts at £968 for a fortnight between the end of April and mid-June, rising to £1,288 throughout the summer. That's for bed and breakfast, and includes return flight from London and transfers between Mahé and Pralin. If you opt for half board, add another £98.
Back here in Babbicombe, the festivities continue. And by the way, a point to note about the weather in the Seychelles. The rainy season is from December to February. And that's all for this week. As usual, the details of all the holidays that we've covered will be on Teletext. Page 197 on Oracle, page 20031 on Prestel.
Next week, it's Fly Drive in Spain and Portugal, a holiday centre on the Isle of Wight and Yugoslavia. Meanwhile, from all of us here in Devon, have a very happy new year.
Manufacturers sell a million machines every year. Each manufacturer has staked his reputation on being able to give you the cleanest possible wash. They have one vital component in common. This one. Aerial Automatic. The vital component installed in a million new machines every year.
Where you come from, boy?
There's a coffee place.
You steal this someplace, boy?
No.
Put a knife in your equipment. Long life, ever ready gold seal, the heart of the machine.
Who brings you turbo power with revolutionary turbo action, giving you more suction than ever before in an upright cleaner, reactivating the fibers of your carpet? And now who's taken 5 pounds off Britain's best-selling cleaner range? Turbo power from Hoover. Who better?
Your Aunt Agatha, sir. What, hey, Aunt? Have a sherry.
Splendid! Bring me a cream sherry, Jeeves.
Is this a cream sherry, Aunt?
Poppycock. Cream sherry is dark brown. Always has been, always will be.
Excuse me a moment, madam. Actually, a relative. Croft Original, with its light, delicate quality, is quite the thing nowadays.
It is not my thing. Ah, that's more like it, Jeeves.
I say, Jeeves, where did you get that from?
From the kitchen, sir. I understand they use it in the trifle. Oh, Jeeves.
Croft Original Pale Cream Sherry. One instinctively knows when something is right.
To prove the new Mr. Muscle range tackles the filthiest of jobs with plenty of muscle, we gave it to someone with none. It will devour the greasiest oven. Cold. It restores to new the grimiest of tiles and grouting. In fact, however stubborn a job, it's so powerful it even cuts down on elbow grease. Mr. Muscle loves the jobs you hate.
Morning.
The chef in charge of Finder's Crispy Pancakes takes his job very seriously. Whether he's inspecting ingredients or studying serving suggestions, he never stops. He's even been known to take his work home with him. Finder's Crispy Pancakes, the finest food, frozen.
Whenever your child has a cold or blocked up nose, put a few drops of Carvol on his nightclothes before he goes to sleep.
Teddy's got a cold too, Daddy.
Carvol's soothing vapors will help him to breathe more easily and help him sleep normally, which means everyone can have a good night's sleep. Carvol, for noses and dozes.
You know, the Wish You Were Here team get about, but I know one place they won't be going. They won't be going to the island on top of the world. However, we will be whisking you there at 1:30 this afternoon, because that's the Disney movie offering. But now it's time for the news. In 20 minutes, the Thames area picture, but first the world news from ITN at 1 o'clock.